Good morning, everyone. Egotavach, Shavua Tov. We are continuing here in the words of the Chavetz Chaim, the Sefer, HaMitzvos, HaKotzar. We are in the 14th of the positive commandments, which is the mitzvah to learn Torah and to teach. Remember, you can only teach if you learned and you know the Torah yourself. And we spoke about the obligation that a father has to teach Melamda, his son, that he has to teach his grandchildren as well, as included in that passing on the legacy and the Yerusha, the inheritance of our Torah. And we said that even from a young age, as soon as a child is able to speak, we begin teaching him Torah Tziva Lanu Moshe, the Torah that Moshe Rabbeinu taught us or commanded us. Mayrasha Kehilas Yaakov, it is an inheritance to the Kehila, to the congregation of Yaakov, and we want that child to know you're included in that inheritance. You're part of that legacy, and therefore we do our best to be able to give over the Torah to children, to grandchildren, to our students. Then he writes, V'chayev lisko lo melamed. You are obligated to hire a melamed, a teacher, a Rebbe for your children. Now, whether or not the father learns with his son, which is the obligation, every father has to learn with their children something. However, as we know, most parents are out there, they are busy doing their thing all day long. They are working, they are teaching, they are helping, they are doing chesed. We don't spend the entire day with our children. That's, as we know, maybe our children would be better off if we would spend more time with them. But lemaisa, in reality, that's not the way of the world. So when we send our children to school, it's imperative that a parent is sending their child to a school where they are learning Torah, because we have an obligation to teach our children. If our children are in school all day long and all they are learning is math, science, history, and the like, all of the secular studies, so then how do we fulfill the mitzvah of teaching Torah to our children? And therefore, it is incumbent upon every Jewish parent to make sure that the schools that they are sending their children to are schools or Torah institutions where they are learning Torah, where they are being taught Torah, where they are learning to live a Torah way of life. In that way, by hiring the melamed, hiring someone to teach our children, we are then still able to fulfill this mitzvah. And if that means that you have to spend a little extra money out of your pocket on the tuition, you have to spend a little extra money on a private tutor, and that means you'll have to have one less fun trip that you do for vacation. You'll get the lower grade car instead of the higher. So you'll drive a Honda instead of driving a Lexus. What's going to be? So what? So your children will know Torah. So when you want to buy a house, you'll buy a house with one less room or a thousand less square feet. For what reason? Because you realize that the ikkar, the main thing, is that you should have the money that you need to support your children in their learning, because you have an obligation to hire people to learn with them. So whatever you'll need for that sake, whatever you need to be able to do that, that's going to be part of the obligation over here. The chayav lisko lo melamed, to hire a teacher, a Rebbe for your children. They should be able to learn properly, whether it's in the school, whether it is even privately. They need tutoring. Maybe they're weak. Maybe they got a late start. Maybe things don't click in their mind like it does for some of the other kids. They need extra help. You have to make sure you get a tutor. This kid needs to feel confident about himself when he walks into the classroom, so that when the teacher calls upon him to read a verse or to answer a question, this child feels good. He says, I know what I'm talking about. He comes to a test, he's not jittery and nervous and anxious for every single test, because you got him a tutor. You got him a Rebbe to learn with. You got him someone that's going to be able to teach him so he'll understand it better. Not every parent and child is a good match in learning. This is just understood. Some children and their fathers, they click very well together. Some of them don't click very well together. And therefore, if you need to hire someone else to learn with your son or your child to be able to get ready for the classes, to get ready for the test, it's no skin off your back. And it's nothing wrong with you or nothing wrong with your child. It just means that he needs something else, a different approach, a different voice, a different word, a different way that he's going to be given over. And therefore, the mitzvah of hiring a melamed is something that is so important. And therefore, please, let's spend our money in the right way. Let's not waste it all away on the things that are frivolous, that are transitory, that are going to end up leaving this world. take the money, put it into a good tuition for a good school where they're going to teach your children Torah. If your child needs extra help at the end of the day and you're not around to do it, or you're not the right one to do it, go and find a tutor. Baruch Hashem, there's plenty of Yidden and Klal Yisrael that could use some extra money. They'll be happy to tutor your children. And in that way, we will fulfill the mitzvah that we have of teaching over children, v'shinantam levanecha, teaching over the Torah to the next generation. Have a wonderful day.